Where is Muhammad Gurdin? My boy right there. Mr. Biles! Guys, are you guys?
Your graduating class of 2018, give them a hand.
Hey, class of 2018. I'd like to disagree with De La Garza. I think the most difficult part was actually waking up this morning. Anyway, my name is Matthew Boucher, and I'm going to be one of your Masters of Ceremonies. Please also welcome Nayeli Hernandez, your other Master of Ceremonies. And now everyone remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the Colorado 21 Rolling Thunder Color Guard and the singing of the National Anthem by the Aurora Central Trojanaires.
Thank you. President Marcy Ivey, Vice President Dr. Kayla Armstrong-Romero, Treasurer Kevin Cox, Secretary Deborah Berkick, Directors Dr. Dan Jordan, Kathy Wildman, and Monica Colbert. Superintendent of Schools, Rico Pumon, Chief of Staff, Marcelina Rivera, Chief Financial Officer, Brett Johnson, Aurora Public Schools Action Zone Executive Director, Dr. Lamont Brown, and Dr. Judy Dolman, Aurora Central Administration, Principal Gerardo de la Garza, and Assistant Principals, Dr. Garrett Douglas, Katie Law, Jennifer Fox, and Shaniqua Brown, Senior Dean Julie Davis, and Senior Counselor Kelly Benson, Faculty Heralds Brandy Caswell, Heather Morton, Michael Smith, Kevin Rigaud, Amanda Vincent, and Sharon Summers. Our top 10 valedictorian, Stephen Asher. Madeline Mercado Aleman, Yvonne Rodriguez Garcia, Daniel Panuelos, and Armonia Mutsugai. Top Children Honors, Christopher Parrish, Elaine Donman, Christian Wells, and Tremon Rice.
All right, now, up next, please welcome your Aurora Central Trojanaires and Centralettes who will be dedicating This Is Me to the graduating class of 2018.
Thank you.
Central Trojans. Our mission has been to become global leaders who have the knowledge, skills, and habits of mind necessary to shape a successful future. Each of us here at Central has been through different challenges. Whether it is poverty, hunger, immigration statuses, we've each overcome our own obstacles to get here today. Now we're going to hear a few words of wisdom about what it means to be this kind of future leader. So please welcome our first speaker, Kobe Randolph.
Thinking about. Green symbolizes renewal, energy, growth, harmony. It can mean jealousy, but that in that case, not with us. Although I see a little bit of green in me, Mr. G's eyes, because I'm the best looking brother up here. So these symbolisms made me think of like my own story and what made me renew myself. So one day in junior year, right, I was ditching. And so I'll tell you, like, anytime I was ditching, I would never answer the phone. But that day also was bold. My mom called me, and I answered. And she's telling me, like, hey, like, how you doing? How's your day at school? Where you at? I'm like, I'm doing good. I'm at school. Like, of course. She just calls me out. You're lying. If you were at school, this white lady would be at my house saying you're not here. You have been at school all day. I'm stuck. I'm like, huh? Like, I didn't know what to say, so. So like, I'm just trying to make up a lie, and I was like, okay, well, I'm not at school, I'm at lunch. She's like, well, come home right now, she wants to talk to you. I try to lie and say I'm like 45 minutes away, but and I just heard like this faint voice in the background. It's like, it's okay, don't worry, I'll wait. So I knew I had to go. So I got home like 10 minutes later. So I see Ms. Doyle, she's at my house, and she's just breaking it down to me, telling me, I'm not gonna graduate in time. She told me I'm gonna be a super senior. Maybe a super, super senior. And there's nothing super about that. You guys know that. When I heard that, my heart sank to the pit of my stomach. I got this uneasy feeling, kind of burned a little bit. I don't know. I wasn't even here yet, and I was worried about not graduating. That was tragic. My vision was like blurred with red because of the anger I had that let myself sink so low. I didn't want to finish this school year, yet it won't even start the next. I didn't want to fall like that. So I told myself I had to get it done. I couldn't let the people that I care most about down. My mom, myself, my son. I want to say, he'll actually say I've done something. He succeeded. I told myself I have to make it. So I came to school this year and I knew I was gonna take everything I had and I was willing to give it all. Every day I had to grind through perseverance and dedication. I came to school early, I left late. I was determined to get work done. Improve myself every chance I got, no matter the doubts or odds stacked against me. I had to walk with you guys today. I had to make sure everyone who doubted me believed me. Nothing is ever over until you stop. Now, can you all sit here and think of that moment that made you recall? Can you all sit here and recall that moment that made you say, yes, I will? We all have that one vivid memory etched into our mind that drove us to know that today will be our day. Green symbolizes togetherness. We spent 4 years bonding and growing with each other, building friendships, some more than others, making memories, some that will keep forever. Today's the day we pass the threshold into life. Today was a way for us this freshman year. Today's the day we graduate. And now that's here, it's more emotional than I expected it to be. Our entire life, we're told to come to school, graduate, it seemed like the finish, but it's not, it's just the start. This graduation is just a stepping stone into our future. Thank you to the parents who helped my parents be here, and thank you to the teachers who have shaped and prepared us for this moment. I know it took a lot for all of us to get here. Perseverance, determination, and self-will. I'm glad to say we all made it, and for those who didn't, don't stop, keep going, come back. It's never over. Achieve your goals. Thank you, Mom, for always cussing me out when I wasn't acting right. You know, it's all over for you. Especially Danielle, thank you for being friends and being an actor. Hey, thank you to my teachers this year, Mr. Cooley. You're a real funny guy with Mr. Nonstop Black. Hey, Mr. McQueen, you gave me confidence to do math in front of the classroom, so thank you for you. Mr. Valdez, you gave me all the food and the snacks, and you're just a really funny guy. Thank you. Good luck. Thank you. Hey, my main man, Mr. Mitchell. Hey, I like your style, and you're very good looks. And I'm sorry, but like last but not least, I'd like to give thanks to Ms. Krovis Martinez. You guys believed in me before I even believed in myself. I owe a lot of my success to you guys. Thank you. And Ms. Krull, I can't explain the words of gratitude I have for you. You're the one who put me into this program, Aurora Central Career Academy. And it really changed me, and it got me on track, and it shaped me for the better. Oh, and one last thing about green, it means go. Now let's go into the road and leave our mark. Go out and do what loves you. Oh, Dallas, go out and pursue that long career. Tyler, go to college and move your life out. Hey, Chris, go to the Christian club book and deflect every pass thrown towards any receiver towards you and like anywhere around you. I expect great news from us all. Hey, Shorty, Mark, Chris, I got you. Donnie, got my boys. Oh, and last, let's go party. Much class, 2018, it's been a blast.
Part and accustomed to the many cultures and people at this very diverse school. Around here is where I started procrastinating, writing my speech, and continue watching The Office. I just thought you guys might want to know that. Then after I wrote these two lines, I went on YouTube and started watching an abundant amount of valedictorian speeches, looking for ideas of what I should say. Or at least that's what I was telling myself. But I knew it was just another way to avoid writing the speech deep down inside. After an hour or so of watching these videos, a Nike ad had played. And at the end of the video, of course, it said, just do it. I took this as a sign that I should get back to writing my speech in 6 to 8 in the morning. Everyone finds motivation in different places and at different times. Henry Ford once said, whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right. Let's be honest, it wouldn't be a speech without a quote, am I right? But in these words do lie true. Your attitude towards what you want to accomplish in life, whether you like it or not, largely determines your success towards what you want. My absolute favorite quote is from the man on the $100 bill. Some people die at 25 and are not buried until they're 75. Your interpretation of this quote may be different than mine, and that's okay. But what's not okay is living to satisfy someone else's wishes. You may lose your way, but that doesn't mean you can't find it again. Sometimes it's not our choice and we're forced off the path we wanted to take, but there is always, and I mean always, a way back, even if that way back isn't the easiest path to take. Too many people waste their lives doing what their parents want them to do for what will keep them safe and secure for their whole life. I can tell you that from the day I walked into Central, I knew I wanted to be valedictorian, and I knew it wasn't going to be the easiest thing to accomplish in the world. But I wanted it. Here I stand, 4 years later, finally having reached my goal. But here I also stand nervous because I'm unsure of what the future holds for me. Yet excited just as all you should be, because I'm sure, just as all you should be, because of all the possibilities that await all of us. Motivation arises from yourself, so I'm not going to stand here and try to yell motivational quotes, because they'll go through one ear and out the other. At the end of the day, how bad you want something to be, why you get it or not. All I can say is every day is a new beginning. Don't let one bad day steer you away from success. This is where I scrolled through Twitter for 10 minutes, because I ran out of things to say this afternoon. Seriously, I don't expect to give you chills with my words of wisdom because I still have so much more to learn. But my fellow classmates, listen when I say that all you will do great as long as you realize that you all have shortcomings as well and your pursuits are great. No one's destiny is predetermined. It is natural for our dreams to change in time, but we will always be better for having our